Advanced Photoshop users not welcome. This tutorial is strictly for beginners without any Photoshop experience. In this short tutorial, I'll be demonstrating how to soften skin texture in Adobe Photoshop while preserving the skin texture and keeping it looking natural. In order to successfully complete this tutorial and get immediate results, ignore all other tools on Photoshop and only focus on the ones necessary for this task. Okay, I'm here on my CS5 and I've just opened up this picture of this young woman. As you can see, she's got quite a few freckles on her face, which make her face look blemished and uneven, when in fact she's got really beautiful, soft, smooth skin. But nevertheless, because she has so many freckles on her face, her skin looks blemished and uneven. So this is the original untouched picture. And if I go to the next tab, you see, this is the after. This is what we'll be doing today. I've softened the skin and I've taken any blemishes out. And as you can see, I've done that without affecting the texture of the skin, and it's looking very natural and beautiful and smooth. At the same time, I've done this without removing all the freckles. So this is our project for today. We'll be achieving a professional looking photograph by softening the subject's skin, but at the same time preserving the texture of the skin, keeping it looking natural. So here we are with the original untouched image. It's looking very uneven, but we'll soon fix that. The first thing we have to do is create a duplicate of this layer. So we'll right click on the layer and rename it to retouch. Once we rename it, then you press OK. If you don't have the layer window enabled, you just press on window, layer, or simply press F7 on your keyboard to enable it. We're now going to get rid of spots, pimples and other blemishes using the spot healing brush tool. That's this tool here. To do this part of the process properly, you might have to use your zoom tool to get up close like this and adjust your brush accordingly. For this process, I recommend that the brush is 100% hardness. And once again, to those of you who haven't already, please watch my previous tutorial on how to get rid of spots and blemishes using the healing brush tool. Hi, we're back again. And as you can see, I've evened out the skin with the healing brush tool. I'll now right click on the retouch layer and select duplicate layer to create a copy. We'll name this layer smooth. Once we've done that, press OK, and next we're going to change the layer's blending mode to vivid light, like so. We're now going to invert the layer by selecting Image, Adjustments, Invert, or by simply pressing Ctrl plus I on your keyboard. Make sure that you've selected your zoom tool so you can zoom into the image and see it up close. At this point, you might be wondering what's happened to your image, but don't worry, it's still here. We're now going to select a filter. So we're going to go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and adjust the radius. The radius of this tool depends on the resolution of your image. The higher the resolution, the higher the radius. My image is quite high in resolution. Slide this button up and down until the image is showing enough detail. In this case, I'll slide it until the freckles are just about showing, like that. Once you're happy with that, press OK. Next, I'll go to my filters and select Other, High Pass. Again, the radius here depends on the resolution of your image. We want to make it look smooth without making it look unnatural, like this. So for this image, 9.7 pixels is fine. Once you're happy with that, press OK. We now have to mask this layer by selecting this button down here. Make sure that your smooth layer is selected first. Nothing's changed because the layer mask is painted white. This allows the image to show through. What we have to do is inverse the color so that it's painted black to make the layer transparent. Then we can paint the areas we want using the white paintbrush. To do this, press Control plus I on your keyboard. I'm using Windows. Another way to do that is to select the layer mask by clicking your left mouse button and going to Edit Fill. Select black as your fill and make sure that the blending mode is normal and the capacity is 100%, and then press OK. We'll use our zoom tool, that's that magnifying glass here, to fit the picture in our window by right clicking the mouse and selecting Fit on Screen. Make sure that the layer mask is selected. It should be highlighted like this. We'll now paint on the mask the areas of the skin where we want the smoothening effect to show. So we'll select the paintbrush tool, and to get to the settings you press this little arrow on the top, and we have to adjust the size of the brush. We want the brush to be quite large and the hardness to be about 25 to 30%. The brush size should be large but small enough to comfortably paint all edges of the face, like the chin. See, that's a good size. Make sure you've selected the white color by pressing this arrow icon, which switches from foreground color and background color, like this. Just a little note, if you were previously using the paintbrush tool and you had other colors selected apart from black and white, press the other icon, this one here, to revert the colors back to black and white. So now we have the white color selected and the layer mask also selected. We'll start to paint around the face, including the eyes, nose and mouth. We'll fix them later on. As you brush over the face, you can see the smoothening effects coming through. Try following the contour of the face with the brush without overlapping it. If you make a mistake like I just did, you can select the black color by pressing the arrow icon again and simply painting over the mistake until you're happy with the results. Okay, as you can see, I've covered the face now, and what we have to do next is bring back the original texture of the eyes, lips and the nose. The way we do this is by once again selecting the black color by pressing the arrow icon. We'll go up to the brush settings to change the size of the brush. We're going to leave the hardness settings as they are, but we're going to adjust the size of the brush so it's around about the size of her pupil. Something around that size is good. So with our black color selected, first we'll start painting the eyes. You can see as we paint, the eyes come back to life. We'll do the same with the eyebrows, like that. And for the nose, it's only necessary to paint the bottom part like this. Finally, we will also paint the lips. That's basically it. But if you want to make the effects even more realistic, you can adjust the opacity of this layer so that the softening effect is not so intense, like this. Right, now I'm going to select the zoom tool and right click and select actual pixels. There you go, a beautiful healthy looking skin, and we've also preserved some natural freckles. We can now save our document. If you want to save it as a JPEG, you can select File, Save As, select JPEG and hit Save. Thanks for watching this video. If you've enjoyed this video and found it useful, please leave your comments below and subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to give us a thumbs up